Good morning. Welcome to another vlog and another day of crazy hair. What's new? I just got back from Whole Foods and I am going on this whole crazy like spice mix kick. So the new protocol that my trainer has me on includes quite a bit of white rice, which is, wow, it's such a paradigm shift. You know, we've been, I think, fed that carbs are just so bad and to stay away from them or whatever, and they may be, but I think because he has me working out so much, whatever, it kind of goes hand in hand with my workout and the diet I'm on. So I'm eating a lot of white rice. Now, I am actually not the biggest fan of rice in general. Like that's not my carb. My carb, as you guys know, French fries, that's my carb. Potatoes, my carb. Noodles, I really like noodles and stuff. Bread and rice, I don't know, I don't really have a weakness for, which is, I know, kind of strange. But anyway, I'm eating a lot of just white rice. Like one of my post-workout meals is like a cup of white rice. And I was choking it down the other day and I was like, I gotta make this more fun. And so I had some random spices in my cabinet and I, you know, just sprinkled it on top. What a difference. What a difference. A little bit of salt, a little bit of flavor can add. Of course, I'm stating the obvious, but now I've gone on this weird spice kick where I'm just getting all these different mixes, ones that are, you know, really, really colorful, like this chimichurri one. This has, you can probably see, it has quite a bit going on in there, like garlic, parsley, onion, chili flakes, oregano, black pepper, basil, and bay leaf. So this will be really interesting, very tasty. And then I got a shawarma one, which reminds me of college. The amount of shawarma we were eating at 4 a.m. on the streets of New York was just sinful. But anyway, this has like paprika, allspice, turmeric, cumin, garlic, cinnamon, onion, ginger. I was like, oh, that sounds interesting. And I got this one, which is just really simple. And I thought this would be really nice for just those days I want to keep my palate clean. Salt, sage, rosemary, garlic, and nutmeg. I was like, that sounds interesting. The nutmeg really kind of caught my eye. Anyway, do you guys have any any suggestions for spice mixes to just sprinkle on my food, on my white rice, just to kind of jazz it up a little bit? Because, man, just eating plain white rice is... it's okay. Like my husband loves rice. He's like, that's the best diet ever. I'm like, it's not. It's not. Not if you're not like the biggest fan of rice. So anyway, how are you guys? What's going on? I'm just trying to drink my water, get my water in. I had Pilates this morning. I did not have a full on training session. So I have a lot more energy today than I usually do. Usually after my workouts, I'm like, oh my God, it just like zaps me of everything. But I've got a lot of energy today. So what are we doing? You know what? I have to show you what I got at COS. I did a little preview in an earlier vlog. I think that probably actually just went up yesterday. So I did like try everything on. I have feedback for you. I am returning some of the things. So anyway, I want to go through that with you guys. And I want to like organize my closet a little bit more now that I've gotten rid of so much stuff. Again, that was in yesterday's vlog. That felt so good. And I've already divvied out the stuff that I'm going to be sending to Lara to put on Mercari. We decided that we are going to just really focus on like basically the things that are even worth selling, because between, you know, me paying her wage and me shipping them, and shipping is so expensive these days. You know, there were some things in there from H&M that I wouldn't be able to sell for more than like $10. It's just not worth it. So I'm donating that clothing, but I'm sending her some clothing that will be worth putting up on Mercari. So since I did that big closet clean out, I want to start moving some stuff around, get some of my warmer like winter coats kind of out of the way. They're so bulky. They're really like kind of taking up a lot of space, and refold my sweaters and everything and do that sort of thing, and look at my drawers and stuff. Anyway, I wanted to do that as well, especially with some of this new clothing coming in that I got from COS. And that's it. That's my plan for today. I do also have to do some work, like film some videos and edit some things and answer some emails. You know, I'm a broken record. But that's it. That's it. I'm like really excited to have my first, no, my first meal actually does not have rice. No, but every meal after that, or the two meals after that, has rice. So I'm really excited to get to this stuff. What should I try the chimichurri first or the rosemary sage? I think I may try the chimichurri. It just looks exciting. And I like the fact that it has like a little bit of spice. It has those little chili flakes in there. So I think I'll try that later. Okay, let me get ready for the day and not have you stare at me looking like this for much longer. So I'm getting ready for the day and I'm wearing this Lily Silk cardigan and these Madewell jeans. I hauled these in my last PR haul, the one with where Laura was helping me. And I'm trying them, you know, everything on. And I love these two pieces so much. I actually just tried on the wide leg Madewell jeans that are cropped. Those, the denim is different. And so they didn't hang quite as nicely. And they, I don't know, they're like a little tight in the crotch. Anyway, I like these a lot more. So these are just the super wide jeans. The denim is so soft, so, so soft. And I cut off about, well, here, I'll show you. I cut off about that much off the bottom. Yeah, they're really comfortable. They're high rise. The denim, like I said, is super duper soft. So I'll link these down below. I really do like them. There's no stretch to the denim. They're just 100% cotton, but they're very like stonewashed and they're very soft and they're not super thick denim. And then this Lily Silk is so cute. I love it. I love this little like nautical look. I feel like it's hard for you to see all of it, so I'm gonna put my microphone down. But the sleeves are just a little bit long. This is a size large. Lily Silk, I feel like runs like a little bit small, because this fits me like very, very nicely. And I feel like I'm between kind of like a large and a medium these days. But I love it. I love it. I love this look. With my slippers, of course. Okay, so like I mentioned, I got a bunch of stuff from COS, and I've already tried it on. I've already developed my thoughts and opinions on this stuff, so I'll let you know as we go through the pieces, like what I'm keeping, what I don't like, what I do like, et cetera, et cetera. So we're gonna start with a keeper, and I was so surprised by this, and I'm not even sure why I got it. I mean, I do love denim, especially in the summertime. It just seems like a casual, easy to wear sort of material. And I don't know why this caught my eye. I think because it's so kind of tailored looking, but then it has these like frayed short sleeves. And I thought, gosh, I feel like I could probably wear this in a casual way, but also in a really, I don't wanna say dressed up, but like I wouldn't feel like super sloppy, like a typical denim shirt. It just seemed like an elevated denim shirt. And I did get it in a size 6, I think I saw online that maybe it like ran a little bit large. And it's pretty snug. Like it fits right across my bust, but I think I'm fine with it. It's cotton, it's denim. It will stretch eventually. And I just, yeah, I really like how it's frayed and I love the like the denim detailing. These look like jean buttons. And then we've got the gold stitching around the buttons. And it's just really nice. It's soft, but it's a fairly thick denim. I think that's what also caught my eye. I think that's why it has this kind of stiff, sort of tailored, less super casual look. It doesn't look like a sloppy denim shirt. So I just really liked it. And I like the length and all of that. So this is gonna be a keeper. Oh, let me just show you the back. It's just got a straight across yoke. It has a box pleat here. That's it. Super duper simple. So I can see myself wearing this with a skirt, which is how I'm wearing it, which I'll talk about in just a second. Or I can, you know, pair it with like a black pair of pants or navy pair of pants or something. Super easy. So I really like this. Or I could wear it kind of as a shacket and, you know, wear it over a white tee or something. So anyway, this is definitely a keeper. And then I'm not sure that I would wear it with this skirt, but I decided to just try it on with it. I really like this skirt. This skirt is another keeper. When I unboxed this, it really seemed like there was just a lot of material going on and I wasn't sure, you know, how that was going to look on me. Was it going to be flattering, et cetera, et cetera? I think, you know, the length and the volume, it just, it can look very different on different people. I really liked it. I liked it on. I thought it was the right amount of poofiness. There was the right amount of movement, not too much. This is like a cotton poplin. And I really, really like the detailing along the bottom. Just these fun cutouts, this fun, sort of looks like punch hooking here, some fun embroidery as well. All of this like white on white keeps it subtle, but there's like a little bit of interest at the bottom. So I like that. The back is elastic waisted, the front is flat. So it's very, very comfortable. It looks nice, and I can imagine myself wearing it with a lot of different things. It's white, so it goes with pretty much any color. And in terms of style, I mean, I could tuck stuff in because it does have like a flat front, or wear something out. Again, I don't know that I would actually wear it with that denim shirt that I'm modeling it with, but I could go with something, I think with like a softer material, I think would work better with such a flowy skirt. It was a surprising keeper. Yeah, I really like the skirt, and I think it's great, obviously, great for spring, summertime. And I also got these flats, which I previewed for you guys in yesterday's vlog. I really like them. They fit well. I did get a size 39, which is essentially like a nine, American like 8.5 or 9. And they're really comfortable. The leather is very, very soft. And I like that they have the look of an Alaya ballet flat. I really like this different kind of opening here, the big buckle strap. They're just really cute. I feel like I could wear them with trousers, cropped wide leg trousers, with a skirt, all sorts of things. So these are a keeper as well. Very, very comfy. Now these pants are, they're gonna be hard to see because they're just black. In fact, my camera's even having a hard time focusing. But they are just a black cotton kind of poplin woven pant, pockets. There's some deep pleating here, so they kind of remind me of way back in the day, those Z Cavaricci pants. Probably not that deep, not that deep of a pleat and not that thick of a waistband, but they do kind of have that feel, and they are pretty wide leg. So they stay pretty wide all the way down to the cuff. Now, these are a size 8. Yeah, these are a size 8, but because the waist comes in, these are pretty tight around my waist, but these are cotton, there's no elastic to it, so I think that they are going to stretch and give a little bit. So I'm gonna keep these because I do like the pant, and I think they hang nicely. The length is decent. I already have a lot of lint all over it. But yeah, I really like these pants. I need to kind of re-up on basic black pants because I did get rid of them during my spring clean out. A lot of them are too large, or they're just really, really old, like my Everlane, my beloved Everlane elastic waisted pants. Like some of that elastic, I was looking at it and I'm like, these are like barely stretchy anymore, which is probably why they've gotten so big on me. They've just, you know, they're just old. So anyway, I need to replace some black pants, some just easy to wear, like go-to black pants. So I'm kind of envisioning that situation for these. Oh, there, now you can see it. Yeah, here are the deep pleats and side pockets and one back pocket here. So really nice basic pant. The size 8, like I said, like just fits me. Now, this dress was a little disappointing. It's navy blue, and it has this really interesting neck kind of blouse area. So it's just got this extra fabric here, if you can see this extra fabric. And you can button this here so that you get this fold. And in my modeled shots, I think you can probably see it better. You'll see it folded, and then, you know, it looks okay straight on. It looks like, oh, like I've got this little bit of like a cowl neck, almost like this simple but exaggerated cowl neck. But when I turn to the side, all that fabric is sticking out. So just, I don't know, just, it looks odd. And I like clothing that looks a little bit different or has like a different element to it, or, you know, a little bit of interesting draping or something. But this just, I think, falls a little flat. It just kind of stops at being odd. It doesn't look more interesting than that. It just kind of looks like, that looks weird. So I thought maybe let me try opening up the button and then just wearing it like as a cowl neck, but it just looks, it looks like it should be buttoned. And then, yeah, it just, I don't know, it doesn't look incredibly well thought out. So what's most disappointing about returning this dress is this fabric. It is incredible. It is this really smooth, almost silky wool woven. It has almost, do you see that? Like almost a perceptible grain. So it's just this really, really beautiful fabric, but I wish it was maybe just a straight up like shirt dress or something. I would have kept that in a heartbeat, probably ordered it in every color, like one of those situations. But this is, while I think it's taking advantage of the nice drape of the fabric, I feel like this design is a little off. So anyway, this is going back. And this is going back as well, this red dress. I really thought I was gonna like it. I love this color. And I think it's just a nice alternative to all the black dresses that I have and wear. But I don't like this material. It's like, in fact, the exact opposite of the dress I was just holding up. I just feel like this material, it feels, and I think it wears a little cheaply. It doesn't have a nice hand. It feels very, it feels very plasticky. And like, it doesn't hang quite right. You can see that it kind of clings to my midsection, which is not great. You want a fabric that really just sort of falls over you. Yeah, and I didn't really like this at all on me. I'm trying to find the fabric content. Let's see. It is 100% viscose. So that would explain the difference between this and the navy dress, which is wool. So anyway, yeah, this unfortunately I'm returning. And it even has these like panels at the bottom, but because this fabric is not that great, you see a little bit of puckering. It's just not great. It's not great. It just doesn't look nice on. So anyway, returning this. And then this is a keeper. So I just threw this on top of the red dress. I wouldn't wear it this way, but this is a black denim poncho. And I love this. I just think it's a fun version of a jean jacket. I think it will probably, I'll probably be able to wear it more in the warmer months because it's not so closed off, you know, with the sleeves, it's open, but it is denim. There is like a little bit of heft to it, but I just love this. I just think it's such a cool take on a denim jacket, this sort of poncho feel. So this is a keeper for sure. And it's got these little closures down here at the bottom. So you're not just sort of wide open. It keeps it like nice and tidy down here. So I love this. So this is a keeper. This little guy, this is like a little mini dress. It's a tunic mini dress. And I thought I could wear it as like just a tunic, like a shirt over some pants, but it really is, I think it's just a little bit too long for that. It's a little bit too long to be worn as a shirt, but I think it's a little bit too short to be worn as a dress for me. So I don't know, I was kind of on the fence on it. I really like it. I think when it is very, very warm out, it's nice. It's nice to have a short dress on. It's just a little too short. And I think it's because it's so A-lined too, that it really emphasizes how short it is. I wish it was like a little bit, the fabric like was brought in a little bit. So I do think I'm going to return this. I think this is one of those pieces I would end up keeping in hopes that I would wear, but then never actually wear it. So I'm gonna return this guy, even though I think it's really beautiful. And I was telling Lara, because I think Lara would love something like this. She looks great in like tunics. Because she's taller than me, I told her she should get this because this she could wear as a shirt. I just think at my height at 5'5", it's like a weird length to wear as a shirt. So anyway, this is gonna go back. This dress I'm surprised at, but I loved it. So it's navy blue, and sorry, my camera's having a hard time focusing on navy again, but it is a t-shirt top, as you can see, crew neck. It's a t-shirt, so it's a knit material. Oh, there, now you can see it. But the bottom is a woven material, and it's like these panels that are just like cut into the t-shirt, and they're, you know, like laid in on the bias. There's pockets here. I think this is actually a really well thought out design versus this beautiful wool one with the weird cowl neck. This is really nice. And this looks great underneath my Prada cardigan that I can't stop wearing, which is navy. And so, yeah, I'm keeping this. I think this is great for the summertime. Really, really great. It looks great with my Alaya fishnet flats. Yeah, it's just, it's easy and a little bit more than just like a simple t-shirt dress with this really interesting bottom here. And then this set, this tan and gray set. So here's the shirt. It's like color blocked, it's paneled. And then there was a matching pair of pants. Same idea, paneled, the gray goes down almost like an exaggerated tuxedo stripe, got pockets, almost looks like it has like jean detailing. It's got that top stitching here. Now you'll see as I'm modeling this, neither piece actually fits well. So I got a size large, oh no, size 8 in the top and a size 8 in the pants. So the same size, but the top is big, which is unusual. Usually it's like the other way around for me. And the bottoms are too small. So they like ride up my butt. They do this weird thing like across my hip area. It just not flattering at all. And then the top, not only was it big, but it didn't like sit right. You know how sometimes you put shirts on and the shoulder seam just keeps like falling back? You keep like pulling it forward. I hate that. That makes me bananas, bonkers. It's like the equivalent of a sock that's lost its elastic and it just keeps falling as you're walking and then eventually ends up under your heel and you just want to like, you just want to punch a wall. Anyway, that's like the equivalent. And that's what this shirt was doing. It just kept falling back. And I don't know why. I mean, it just wasn't, I just don't think it's cut well. So anyway, this outfit is going back, much to my disappointment. This was the outfit I was actually most excited for. I love the colors. I love the idea of it. I love that, you know, you could wear like this matching outfit and it look really, really nice, but it's not like you're in a suit or anything too fancy schmancy or too formal looking. But yeah, it's going back. And then last but not least, this dress. Now when I unbox this dress, and you can actually see, it's very, very see-through. So I will definitely have to get a slip or something for it, but I love this dress on. I think it looks really, really pretty. I love all the ruffles on the side, and I really like this cotton voile fabric. It's very, very soft. It's softer than like a poplin. Poplin's pretty stiff. And it just has like enough drape, but not too much. It's not too silky where it's just kind of lifeless or too limp. Yeah, I just thought it was really beautiful. I like the length of it and yeah, and just like the way it hung on me. I was a little bit curious because it is asymmetric. So the flutter sleeve on this side is longer than the flutter sleeve on this side. You can see this is more of like a cap sleeve. And I was like, is this crooked? Like what's going on? But then I realized, oh, it's asymmetric. I'm like, okay. And then there's a very deep opening in the back. So if I don't wear it with a slip and just wear like a bra underneath, I'd have to wear a very pretty bra because the bra strap, you can see it in the back. And I have to wear a bra. I can't go braless. So anyway, very, very pretty dress. And I really like this fabric as well. So this guy is a keeper.
I don't think I told you guys anything that's been going on with our pool. Hold on, maybe you get a better view here. No, sorry. I don't want to go outside because every time I open up the sliding door, Butters gets really, really excited. And she wants to go outside and I can't let her out because there's all these hoses and stuff draining the water out. So let me sit down. So a few months ago, no more than that. I mean, several months ago, my husband was looking out at the pool at night. We have these lights in the pool and they actually change color. They go from like blue to purple to green, really pretty. And one end of the pool just looked a little bit dark. He was like, does that look darker to you? And I'm like, a little bit. I wonder if it's just like shadow. We couldn't really tell. And then we kind of forgot about it. And then, you know, the next night we noticed it again. So we went out and we saw that one of the light bulbs in the pool was out. And we were like, oh, shoot. And I'm like, no big deal. Whatever. Like the pool is still, it's still lit. Anyway, fast forward a couple months and another light bulb goes out. I was like, so now like half of the pool is dark. And I'm thinking, okay, the light bulbs are like in the pool. So they're like under the water essentially. And I thought there's no way that you have to drain the pool to change these light bulbs. They must've thought of some smart design because we're beyond that now, right? Like these are light bulbs that need to be changed Nope, you have to drain the pool. Now, that's not the only reason why we're draining the pool for these light bulbs. We figured, what else can we do? You know, why do people drain their pools? This is the first time we've ever had a pool. So we're like, do you do that every once in a while and put fresh water in? Like, we weren't even sure. So anyway, we're talking to our pool guy. And he was like, well, you know, if you take care of your water and keep the chemicals at the right level or whatever, he's like, you shouldn't have to drain your pool often. But you may want to, like, acid wash the pool because the water here in Vegas is very hard and blah, blah, blah. So that's what we're doing. We're draining the pool essentially for those light bulbs, but also to acid wash the pool and to get some fresh water in there because, I mean, this house was built probably 4 years ago at this point. So that's what we're doing. And I, you know, I kept telling my husband, I was like, oh, just put it off. Because, you know, there's quite a bit of an expense to it for the pool guy or whatever, but really for the water. My husband was like, if we don't do it now, we're going to have to wait until after the summer, because in the summertime, water here is so expensive. Like, so, so expensive. Our water bill goes through the roof. So he's like, if we don't do it now, we have to wait until, like, October. When does summer technically end? Like October or November. And he's like, I don't want to wait that long. So we're doing it now. And in fact, we probably should have done it before because I think the water rates just went up for this month. Anyway, we're doing it now, but we'll have a fresh, new, clean pool. Oh, I didn't show you guys. This just came in the mail. Luna sent me one of these new macrame necklaces. If you caught the last chat that Luna and I had in a vlog, probably a couple weeks ago now at this point, we talked about these macrame chains. They do come with a clasp. You can, you know, get whatever kind of gold you want. But this macrame is so cool because it's stiff. You know, it's not just like a string or whatever. It's really, really tightly woven. It's very, very strong. And I actually just opened it up and put this on, but upstairs I've got my baroque pearl pendant that I can hang off of this. But I just love this rope because it just looks so nautical to me. And I'm wearing this, it's very kind of like nautical cardigan today. So I just thought it was a nice mix, but I really want to put the pearl on there. And I think I may buy maybe like a black one would look cool, or just see what other colors they have. I think she had a few colors that she could use. I love this like beige khaki one. It's so cool. But speaking of what I got in the mail, I did get some other interesting PR. Let me just show you quickly. I got something from Pat McGrath. I got their new under eye powder in baby pink. So this is that really beautiful blurring powder. I used, I believe this, no, these two shades I used kind of between these two. And I think this will actually work out nicely. Kind of reminds me of, is it Bubble? The one from Westman Atelier? It has like a similar look and feel to it, but I'm gonna have to open this up. When I feel like dealing with sequins, I will open that up and I'll probably try it for you in a future video. They also sent the concealer in L3 and L5, the Sublime Perfection Concealer, and also their blush brush, which will be great for the powder. Thank you very much, Pat McGrath. That's so nice. I don't usually get PR from them, but that's really a lovely surprise. And then SkinCeuticals sent me their CE Ferulic Serum. So look at this box. It's like so serious. Yeah, CE Ferulic. Number one dermatologist recommended vitamin C serum. All right. Combination antioxidant containing 15% L-ascorbic acid, 1% alpha tocopherol, and 0.5% ferulic acid. I don't know if this is good for sensitive skin, but I should give it a shot. Yeah, I think this is good for like, oh yeah, fine lines and wrinkles. It says right here. How cool. Thank you very much, SkinCeuticals. And then Finding Ferdinand sent over delicious balms, tinted lip balms, which you guys know I love. And it looks like there's three shades, Feminist, Photo Shoot Red, and Lucky Cat. And, oh my God, the packaging is green. Oh, this is so great. Let's see. We've got, here's Lucky Cat. Ooh, Asian Pear. Let's see how tinted these are. Oh, that's pretty. It's a little pinkier on the skin than it appears in the bullet.
That's really pretty. Okay.
Photo shoot red. This is black cherry. Ooh. Yeah, that's a pretty red. Ooh, so nice. And then this is feminist. This is a watermelon. Oh, pretty. That's kind of a pink. So we've got kind of like a pink, a red, and a plum. This kind of smells like watermelon. Wait, do they all smell different? Hold on. Mm-hmm. I think they all smell like the fruit. Black cherry. I think so. The watermelon, I think, is the most obvious out of the three. Yeah, this smells like watermelon. Oh my gosh, you guys, this reminds me of like all the lip balms I had when I was little. And they would smell a certain, you know, flavor, and the color and all the packaging would all be like aligned with the color and the scent, everything. So that is watermelon. Oh, how fun. Oh, I love that. Thank you, Finding Ferdinand. That is so cute. Yes, delicious balms. Oh, I love these. Mouth-watering lip balms with a hint of color, which provide hydration and comfort that you can apply all day. And then Lawless sent me a bunch of their Forget the Filler lip glosses. So they have 7 shades, and they sent me all 7 shades. Wowza. Definitely gonna have to try these out. Let's try one. I'm tempted by this rosy outlook. This is the super sheer baby pink, this guy right here. And I'm not sure when this video is going up, maybe on Sunday, but the spring savings event at Sephora is going on, and of course Lawless is there. So they added that to their little mailer here. Ooh, I love how pale that is. Let's see how this feels. Ooh, this doe foot applicator is really neat. It looks like when you do this. Mm. Very fruity. I'm putting it right on top of that Finding Ferdinand. Can always use more lip balm. But it's nice. I don't feel anything like minty or spicy. I'm not like really into super high shine, and I don't feel like I see that. So that's good. I feel a little mintiness. Tired of plumpers that sting the lips for a short-term plump? At Lawless, the plump lasts even after you take off your makeup thanks to serious skincare credentials with a high concentration of Maxi Lip and a proprietary blend of gold standard ingredients. But how does it look in the moment? Yeah, there's definitely I feel a bit of mintiness, but it's not too much. And I feel like I feel it more than it's actually bothering my lips. You know, that kind of like mentholated feel. Oh, it's nice. That's nice. Wow, thank you very much, Lawless. Oh, they even included this Lawless lip mirror. Oh my God, that's so cute. That is adorable. I love this.
Okay, and something from Bobby Brown. Line Define Go.
All right. Sorry, this is what I'm looking at. So it looks like we've got new liners. And then these are their cream shadow sticks, which we all are very well acquainted with. So these are the 3 new shades. We've got Incandescent. Oh, this isn't new. Or maybe they're making this permanent. But this used to be one of their luxe eyeshadows. So this has like an iridescence to it. It's like a peach base, but then it flashes to like different colors. Really pretty. Golden Light. Ooh, this is like a bronze. Wow, that's bright. And then the 3rd one is Bronze. Why do all these sound familiar? But there is Bronze, and apparently these are all new. So Bronze, Golden Light, and Incandescent.
That's exciting. And then we have some limited edition ones.
So they come in this packaging, and the colors look very mermaid.
Opal. Let me just swatch them all, and then I'll hold up my hand. Oh, that's pretty.
Okay, so these 4 shades here, we have Opal, Golden Fern, Sunset Rose, and then Periwinkle. They're very light. They're very pastel-y, except for this Sunset Rose shade. This one is the deepest.
Oh, wow. Well, thank you so much, Bobby Brown. And then these are just like eyeliners.
They're kind of a chubby stick, these eyeliners. There's 5 colors. Black, I'm guessing this is black. Panther, they're calling it. Aubergine. Just like a deep plum. Let's see, fog, which is like a gray, rich chocolate, deep brown, and then jungle, which is like this khaki green. Even more ways to play the number one eyeshadow stick, now in a liner. Everything you love about our original longwear cream shadow stick, now in a fine tip design. I see. Okay, so these are just the cream shadow sticks, but with a fine design, which is great because these are very, very long wearing, and I do like applying them like right along my lash line as an eyeliner, so it's really nice to have them with this tip now because the tip on the eyeshadow sticks is rounded. I had to make some tea because I was freezing. It stays really cold in Vegas in the shade, so like in your house or whatever, until it's just like really like broiling outside. So yeah, it's so interesting. If I were to go outside and stand in the sun, I'd be probably pretty hot. But like in my house, it's like chilly, which is why I'm always wearing like a sweater or I'm layered and I'm sipping like coffee and tea. It's just, yeah, it's so cold in here. Something new from Persona. Whoa, look at those metal. Those metal bands. And they also threw in a dual-ended brush. Oh, how cool. The packaging reminds me of those Glossier liquid eyeshadows that they came out with. I don't know if they still have them. I don't think they did that well. They were very sheer, and I didn't mind them, but they were a little difficult to like get like a nice even coverage of. Anyway, these, these look like they'd actually go really well with the Bobbi Brown shadow sticks. Water resistant, comfy, weightless, no fallout, high coverage, long lasting. Wowza. Again, I feel like a very young Michelle would have been all over this. Oh my goodness, I don't even think the camera's picking up how glittery and like shiny this is. And then Oro is a warm metallic amber gold. Here is Oro. These are nice because they're light and they really are weightless. Oh, how neat. And then the last color is Belle, which is described as a warm metallic bronze. Wow. Okay, Persona. This is kind of different for them, but so much fun. And I like these three shades they came out with. We've got a nice variety here to play with. That's so awesome. Thank you, Persona. All the eye products I swatched are very long wear. They're not coming off. Oh, and then Origins sent me this. Look how cute this little box is. It's like a little lunchbox. This is, let's see, the new Mega Mushroom Dark Spot Corrector Serum. So there's two in here. Mega Mushroom Dark Spot Corrector Serum. And this one is Mega Mushroom... Oh, Restorative Skin Concentrate. So there's two products in this Mega Mushroom line. Well, thank you very much, Origins. How exciting. Oh, and these are the clinical results, by the way. And this is a box from Irene Forte. They're a wonderful skincare brand. So they're a natural skincare line, I believe based out of Italy. Looks like they sent me a couple of their things. The Phytomelatonin Rejuvenating Serum. Oh, okay. And then they also sent, oh, their Hibiscus Night Cream. Oh, here, sorry, this packaging looks a little dirty because of the padding that they had in the box. But here's what their packaging looks like. It's so pretty, it looks like stone. And here is the night cream. Oh, ooh, fresh. Really fresh fragrance. That's very nice. So smooth and rich. Thank you so much, Irene Forte. And then I've got something from Aquas. Oh, so I always forget Aquas and I believe K18 are under the same company. So it says it's from Aquas, but I usually have something from K18 in there. Okay, this is the Airwash, ooh, dry shampoo. Nice, the reinvention of dry shampoo. Newly patented Odor Bind, smart release biotechnology, recognizes, suspends, and eliminates odors for up to 3 days, even on 4 day unwashed hair. Well, that, okay, I'm not a fan of not washing your hair. I know, I think I'm in the minority, but I think you should at least wash your scalp. But for those of you who don't wash your hair that often, this seems like a good remedy. Air wash, dry shampoo. Thank you so much, K18. Ah, this is from Roan. This is a perfume brand. They actually reached out to me. They're a small company and they wanted to send me their perfumes. I think they have three different kinds. And I was so intrigued. You guys know how much I enjoy fragrance. So, you know, I said, of course, I would be honored to try out your fragrances. So let's see here. Embrace the nomadic spirit within. Dear Michelle, I'm so excited to share with you our full collection of transportive tea fragrances. Each one is designed to awaken and inspire the wanderer within. Oh, that's so amazing. Here's what the bottles look like. Oh, wow. So here's one. It's called Current Culture. And this one has white ginger matcha as one of the notes. It also has bergamot zest, which makes me very excited. Oh, look how beautiful this bottle is. Gorgeous. Really fresh. Really fresh and light. I love that. Roots of a Nomad. And it is an EDP, so it's an eau de parfum. This next one is Mountain Memories, and this one has black currant bud jasmine tea in here. And there's leather and oak moss and guaiac wood, patchouli. This one I think is gonna be a little deeper. A little deeper and probably a little bit more unisex. Let's see. So here is this bottle. Oh yeah. It's still really clean and fresh, but it has more, you know, masculine notes in there. Oh, that's really nice. It's very sophisticated. Oh, I love that. I would definitely wear this. Mountain Memories. And then last but not least, we have Porcelain Pulse. And this has black tea, Darjeeling, musk, tobacco, rhubarb. Wow, this has a lot of notes in here. Carrot is the first note in here. And I don't think I've ever seen carrot listed as a note. So now I'm really intrigued. Wow, there's like a lot going on in here. Let me read these notes again. Carrot, rhubarb, pear, black tea, cardamom, peony, lily, dried apricot, Darjeeling, musk, vetiver, amber, tobacco, and hay. That is so interesting. I don't think I've smelled anything like this. It's like, it's constantly changing and shifting. At first I was like, oh, that seems very fruity and like citrusy and zesty. And then it really rounded out. Now I feel like, what am I smelling? Oh, like the lily. And now I feel like the deeper notes are coming in, like the vetiver and the amber. Wow, this is really cool. Porcelain Pulse. How interesting. Well, if you're tempted by any of these, they all smell really great, but this one is so interesting. Porcelain Pulse. Oh, that's wonderful. Thank you so, so much. Good morning. I'm back from the gym and our pool is fully drained. Isn't that crazy? Now all of that, I think all of that kind of whiteness over the tile, that's all gonna be acid washed clean. Because we have really hard water here in Vegas, it just kind of leaves this residue everywhere. And then our lights are gonna be fixed, so I'm really excited to to see our pool's like facelift here. It's getting like a nice spa day. There's the gentleman that runs the pool company that we're working with. Such a nice guy. If anyone's here in Vegas and needs a reference, he's not cheap, but he's really good, super reliable, shows up every week to maintain our pool. Really nice, really professional. Yeah, he's great. He's great. Anyway, I am just kind of running around today. I have a bunch of boxes that I have to bring to the UPS store to ship off. My returns to COS, and then I have three boxes going to Lara for the Mercari store. And then I have to run to Costco because I was doing some meal prepping earlier today and realized we are done with protein. No chicken breast, no ground turkey, no fillets, no nothing, except for salmon. And I can do salmon like once a day, but I cannot be having salmon like lunch and dinner, or seafood, I should say, like lunch and dinner. As much as I love it, I can't do it like all day, every day. So I got to go to Costco, and my mom and my aunt, they're coming over later. It's just one of those days, kind of busy, you know, things are kind of scattered all over the day. And I was supposed to have a yin session with Jen today. You know, I've been doing yin yoga with my friend Jen every week, just for a half hour. And I had to cancel on her because I'm like, I'm sorry, I'm just like running around and my schedule got completely messed up. And, you know, and I feel it. I feel it. I'm going to have to sit and do pigeon or something for like 7 minutes. 7 minutes each side. Anyway, I am going to load up the car with all these boxes. And I'm gonna shower because Costco does not open until a little bit later. I'm actually always so surprised at Costco's hours. They open late, they close pretty early. I'm like, come on, Costco. I wish they opened at like 7. That's my dream. But they open at 10 here. I should double check that, but I think they open at 10, 9:30 or 10. I'm rambling. I'm just rambling here. I'm just getting ready for the day. I put on my Baroque pearl onto this macrame rope chain from Luna. She sent over one with an 18 karat rose gold clasp. Doesn't that look so cool? It's such an interesting juxtaposition between something that is, I think, traditionally thought of as more of like a formal piece, a pearl, and then this really kind of casual rope. Oh, I love it. I just have a black t-shirt on. I think I got these tees at like Costco or something. They're just basic black tees. But I'm wearing my Fear of God sweatpants. I love these. I love these. I will link them down below because they're just so, so great. I have a size medium. They are, of course, meant to be oversized. And you know what's interesting about them is that they're just like a typical sweatpant material, but they're inside out. So that French terry like loop fabric, you know, that's usually on the inside of sweatshirts, it's on the outside. I just love it. It gives it like a little bit of a different look and feel and texture and everything. It's just fun. And they have pockets, and the elastic at the ankle is black. I love that little addition. I mean, you can only like see it peek out every once in a while because so much of the sweatpant kind of folds over it, but I know it's there and I really love it. So anyway, I'm trying to figure out what to put on top. I was thinking my Lululemon half zip. It has like a green tint to it, which I think would be nice over these sweatpants. Okay, what do we think? I kind of love this. I love this necklace with everything. Who would think a pearl necklace would look great with basically like a sweatsuit? But I love it. Oops, kicking my shoes around. Yeah, I like these colors together. They're different enough. All right, skincare is done, hair is blown dry. I guess it's time to run all those errands.